Before we start to pray, let us give the Lord praise and worship, for He is worthy of all our praise. Let us acknowledge His presence and give Him reverence. Now, let us proclaim His goodness towards us as we humbly come before Him and pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You for being with us and being gracious towards us. Forgive us for our sins and wrongdoings. Cleanse us from all unrighteousness and have mercy on us. We bless You and thank You for Your goodness and grace. In the name of Your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You are the Lord our God, a compassionate God, full of mercy in all Your ways. You do not withhold Your love from anyone, but instead, You lavish us with love more than we deserve. You love us unconditionally, despite of what we do or who we are. Your grace covers a multitude of sins, and Your healing and salvation is ever present. You are not a respecter of person, nor do You hold grudges. We can always rely on You no matter what situation or circumstance we are in. You are faithful to Your word even when we lose faith, because You know our weaknesses and our shortcomings. Your ways are always for our good, and Your love for us is beyond all understanding. You are patient and full of grace in all Your ways. You are my God who created all the heavens and the earth and everything in it. You willfully allowed Yourself to become lower than the angels and to be crucified and die that we may live. As it is written in the book of Isaiah, He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on Him, and by His wounds, we are healed. You took upon Yourself all of our sins and all of our sickness by crucifixion and death on the cross to redeem us from condemnation, that we are made righteous. You also suffered the agony of shedding blood by the wounds You endured for our healing. We are healed through Your death and suffering. The book of Matthew says in chapter 14, verse 14, "And when Jesus went out, He saw a great multitude, and He was moved with compassion for them, and healed their sick." My Lord Jesus, as You have been moved by the great multitude when they came to You, today I am coming to You as well. I am asking You, Lord, humbly praying to You as a child of God, that my condition may also move Your heart. I am praying that You may also have the same compassion on me as You had for the multitude, as You healed their sick. Lord, I come to You in deep prayer. Have compassion on me and heal me of this sickness and whatever is attacking my body. I am asking You, my Lord Jesus, to please have mercy on me. I pray that my cry for help may also move Your heart and bless me with healing. Touch my body, Lord, and remove all this pain and suffering I am going through. I am so helpless without You. Be merciful to me, my Lord, and preserve my body. Keep me safe from all harm. Cleanse me, Lord God, and remove whatever sickness I may have. Rebuke this pain and suffering, Lord, and be merciful on your servant. I do not have any other source of healing but from you alone. I do not look up to any other, for they are limited in knowledge and resource. You are God, our healer. Please hear my cry and have mercy on me. Heal me, O Lord, as you have done so in the past. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. So there is nothing impossible with you. I am desperately in need of your mercy and compassion. The people who came to you for healing got healed because you had compassion on them. I also come to you today, but I come to you by your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of the Father that dwells in me. Please hear my prayers and hear my cry. Hear me when I call on your name. You are my Lord and my God, who went to the cross for our healing and deliverance. You said in your word in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 23 to 25, who, when he was reviled, did not revile in return. When he suffered, he did not threaten, but committed himself to him who judges righteously, who himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sins, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes you were healed. For you were like sheep going astray, but have now returned to the shepherd and overseer of your souls. I praise you, my God and Father. Please be mindful of my body and my condition. I give you my heart, my body, and soul. Do not let the enemy win. Destroy whatever the enemy has assigned for my defeat. I am yours, and all my trust is in you. You are my everlasting God, and there is no one greater than you. I ask you, Lord, by your precious blood that washes me clean, white as snow, heal my whole body. Lord Jesus, please look upon my situation and speak healing into my body. Remember that my life on earth is just like a blade of grass, here today and gone tomorrow. Please look upon me in my weakness. Give me the strength to endure as I wait on you. You know every part of my body, every strand of fiber, every muscle, every cell, even my bones and marrows. You created me, and your eyes have seen my unformed body before I came to be. You have formed every part of my being. You covered me in my mother's womb. You said in your word that you fearfully and wonderfully made me. Lord, I will hold on to your word, for they are true. I believe in my heart that you are ever present and ever faithful. You are the God whose word never fails. My healing is in your hands, and I put all my trust in you. I want to serve you and give you all the glory for my healing. I believe, Lord, in your mighty name, I am healed. My body will conform to your healing word, and every cell, every fiber and membrane, blood, bones, mind, eyes, legs, joints, every part of my body will receive your healing power as I give you all the glory. In the name of Jesus. Amen.